A very good morning, friends, and in this video we are going to talk about the burning topic of the year, or we can say that the week in the news headlines, that is the air quality index, AQI. If you are seeing the news channels or the breaking news or the newspaper, if you are studying, you will see that the air quality index, or the AQI, is level is determined in the form of the number. A number is going to relate the quality of the air with the difference remarks and the health impacts. If you are having a smartphone, you can click on the weather app and you will get the AQI of your region. If you are a person that is surrounding the Delhi NCR, that is too bad at this time. The place I live, it's the having the AQI is 416. So we are going to check in which remark it's going to be placed. Now, before starting this topic, I will say that it is most important to the CSIR preparing student or the icmr preparing student, because in this two or three questions are asked in the icmr and one question is asked in the previous CSIR examination, that is of the 4 marks on the basis of the matching of the column, that is in the 4 mark about the air quality index. So when we talk about the air quality index, we have to know the few of the things. The government bodies, the authorities who put these we can say that data in the form of this table. So CPCB, that is the Central Pollution Control Board, it is under the control of the central government. But beside this, each and every state is also having their pollution control board. That's control the pollution, that advise the state government. If it is an state pollution control board, the Central Pollution Control Board is the main regulating body. It's advise the central government for reducing the pollutions, for understanding the main reason of the pollution or the death in a particular area. Or if you see that the water spraying or the other methods are also advised by the Central Pollution Control Board. So the it's acts and as advisory committee to the central government. So it is the Central Pollution Control Board. It is a very strong authority in India, we can say that, in controlling pollution, and it is established in 1974. Now the next thing, that is the NAQS, that is the National Ambient Air Quality Standards. In this, what National Ambient Air Quality Standard does, it selects the main pollutant, that is the mainly hazardous to the health of the humans, or the we can say that the biodiversity. So that's the NAQS that decided the 8 pollutants. If you visit the Delhi NCR or any of the metro cities are you from, you will see that the bulletin are placed on the very popular places or the famous places. In Delhi, it is on the Connaught Place, or you will see that near the Indira Gandhi Airport or in the Connaught Place. There are the bulletins are set in which the people are informed about the concentration of these pollutants. It's for the life science student, for CSIR, it is difficult to memorize the concentration of these pollutants exactly, but we can memorize the air quality index. If you see once in your smartphone, you are easily to remember the air quality index, or you will tell the air quality index of your region to the other peoples, and you can also concern the people about the environment, and you can also help the government to stop the pollution. So it's the 8 pollutants mainly that are in the National Ambient Air Quality Standards. That is the carbon monoxide, lead. This question is asked in the CSIR, what is a natural pollutant? There are 4 options are given, and lead is the right answer. So lead is a natural pollutant. This question is asked in the ICMR 2019 of this July. So sulfur dioxide, ammonia, NH3, NO2 is a nitrogen dioxide, ozone. There is 2 types of ozone, that is a good ozone and a bad ozone. So the ozone in the stratosphere region is a good ozone, but when it's created in the lower region, it acts as a pollutant. That is the ozone layer. It also is the main reason for the greenhouse effect. Or it is a greenhouse gas, ozone, O3. Next is the PM, that is the particulate matter. It is the solid particles that are mainly responsible for the respiratory disease. Or they are also harmful to the plants. They are settled down on the plants as a dirt, and the plants are not able to photosynthesize from the sunlight. Or it is a particulate matter that is a 2.5, it is the size 2.5 or the 10, it is the size of the particulate matter. These are having the main roles in the respiratory disease or in the eyes itching. The SO2, NO2, ammonia, these are the main ones. Carbon monoxide, you know that the methemoglobin is formed. Even you are in the daily, that is equal to if you spend 6 to 7 hours outside, that is equal to that you smoke 6 cigarettes in a day. So it's very, we can say that it is in the severe conditions of our capital. Now is the air quality index. The air quality index parameters are set by the Central Pollution Control Board, and it's checking. Some of the parameters are checked in the 4 hours and some of the parameters are checked in the 8 hours. For example, particulate matter 2.5 and the particulate matter size 10, it is checked out in the 4 hours, while the others mainly are checked out in the 8 hours. So that are shown on the bulletin. So air quality index. Now these are the 0 to 50, these are in table, or we can say that in class. Exactly, it is in class in which give the remark and is the health impact. So the question in the ICMR, I forgot that, is also on the particulate matter 2.5 and the 10. It is an important one. And one question is on the ozone as an greenhouse gas. So it is in the option, which of the following is not a greenhouse gas, and ozone is an option. So that is going to help you in the ICMR too, as well as in the journal life. So 0 to 50, that isn't good, really good, but you rarely seen this AQI. Nowadays, because it's become too difficult to get this AQI in the industries and the automobiles. So good is, you will see that in the rare cases nowadays, and it is having the minimal impact, or we can say that the no effect on the health. That is the telling the quality of the air, that is the air quality index. I write my city index, that is as 416. Now, it is having the minimal effect 0 to 50. Now, let's move further. 51 to 100. From 50 to 51 to 100, that is the satisfactory. In this, there is a minor problem. To the severe asthmatic patient, not to the healthy person, not to the person that are having the heart disease, but to the minor problems to the asthmatic patients. So that is in the satisfactory 51 to 100, it is the minor problem to the asthmatic patient. Now 101 to 200, that is having the moderate. In this, the breathing discomfort start. So when the breathing discomfort start, it's only to the asthmatic patient or the heart disease patients. So in this also there is no effect on the healthy patients. That's why the old people are more prior to the asthmatic or the heart disease in the pollutions or the higher air quality index. So that's the reason the government declared the holidays for the children in the schools, as well as the old people are trying to remain in their home. That's the advisory, that the asthmatic and the heart patient gets effect in the AQI of the 101 to 200. Now let's move further, 200 to 300, that you see generally in the air quality index when you see in your smartphone. 201 means 200 to 300, we can say that is having the poor air quality index. Poor means itching in the eyes and the throat. You will feel, if you remain in a good environment in a village and when you come to the city, you will feel the itching in the eyes and the throat, and also having the some respiratory discomfort at this level when the air quality index is 200 to 300. Now let's move to the further 300 to 301 to 400. That is the very poor. Even after the poor remarks, the healthy people also get start affecting from these pollutants, these types of pollutants. In this, the respiratory illness means the healthy people is get starting suffering from the acute asthmatic problems, eye itching, throat itching. We can also say that the throat itching. I also feel that. Now, come to the last. It is the respiratory illness or the heart disease containing state of the air. That is the 300 to 400. Now, 400 to 500, 401 to 500. Now you can see that my CT index 416. That is in the severe. Actually, I tell that incident when I go to park in the evening or the morning, I will feel that the itching in my eyes and the respiratory discomfort. That is the true thing that happened to me or all of us. That's in the severe air quality index. That's my city air quality index today. Before starting the video, shooting the video, I just check it. That is the 416. So we have to use the masks to prevent our eyes, throats and the lungs. It is the severe one. When you see the this range, mainly around the Delhi NCR, Ghaziabad, Uttar Pradesh type region, you will see that there is always a very poor and the severe. There is always, when it is a heavy raining, the air quality index come to the moderate or to the poor. When it is a heavily rain, the air quality index come to the moderate or the poor, not to the good one. Even you see that after the Diwali, it is comes to the severe. All the years, if you see backs after Diwali, it's come to the severe one. And people have to understand this air quality index. That's make you important. And it's, as a lifestyle student, it's become your duty to aware the people about the air quality index. It's not about the CSIR exam. It's our duty to aware the people about the air quality index. And if you are true lifestyle students, I request you to plant a tree in your life to serve to the humanity. I will request you to do so. So 410 to 500, that is the severe condition, is an eye itching, respiratory system related disease, there is an asthma, that leads to the chronic asthma, lung cancer is also in, also there. Emphysema is also get in the severe air quality index, and the heart disease, just like the BP and the other heart related disease, also in the severe air quality index. Now I hope so you are more aware to the news that you seen in the breaking news, in the newspaper, what is the air quality index or is the AQI, and how the data is formed, what are the pollutants are included. Now one more thing, when these data are prepared, there are three or four things that are going to affect this data. First is the wind blowing, wind speed, we can say that, the direction of wind, temperature and the relative humidity. These are the four things that are going to affect this data. When you see this data around the sea coast, this will change due to the relative humidity. When you see the data in a high temperature region, just like in the Rajasthan, this data will change. So we can say that the air quality index is different for different places on due to these four factors, that is the relative humidity, temperature, wind direction and the wind speed. So these are the four parameters. So it is the Central Pollution Control Board that makes an AQI. I request you please to aware the people about this, and this will also help you in the CSIR examination. It is all about the air quality index. Now I request you to check your air quality index from this table, and also you, this will help you in memorizing this table in the CSIR. So this is all about the air quality index. For the next videos, please subscribe the channels. Thank you so much and all the best for your CSIR examination.